Are you not one of the lucky few who are working with your passion? Let's change that today. Start planning for the day you will walk into the office and say, "I quit." Because this video will give you a full framework for how you can start a side hustle and then turn that side hustle into a full-time job over time. My name is Johan Peterson, and today I'll give you a complete approach on how you can start a side hustle the right way without quitting your day job at first. Stewart Butterfield ran a gaming company, but noticed his employees needed a better way to communicate. So he built a small messaging platform for his employees as a side hustle. When the gaming company shuttered in 2012, he took his messaging platform, his side hustle, to the market. Slack is now worth billions of dollars. Another great example is Sara Blakely, who was selling fax machine for a company called Danka. She started a side hustle out of her Atlanta apartment selling underwear. Today, Spanx is a billion-dollar business. In today's world, there are so many opportunities if you just put in the effort and have the patience to see it through. Whatever your passion is, there are likely ways you can turn it into a full-time job that pays a decent wage. And starting small while maintaining the job you already have, minimize the economic risks. If you're sitting there thinking, "I have no idea what my passion is, but I really want to do this," then I'll leave a link down in the description to a video about how you find your passion in life. So make sure you go watch that first. Let's dive straight into the 10 steps. Set a vision. The first thing is, of course, to figure out what your side hustle will be and what you will be working towards. Do you want to launch a web shop, design an app, start a craftsman's business, or maybe a Fiverr business designing websites? This is where you use your passion as the biggest ingredient into whatever the vision for your side hustle is. Think big and make sure it's a viable full-time job down the line at the very minimum. Your vision may be a smaller company with a few employees, or maybe a charitable organization. Whatever it is, get clear on that vision. Assess the market. Try to assess the market by researching what competition there already is for the niche you've chosen. Is it already oversaturated? If that's the case, figure out what sets you apart. And if that's enough for you to carve out your own little piece of the market, then go make this part of your vision. Identify the target audience. Who will you be selling your future products or services to? You need to identify your target audience and what the key demographic of that audience is. Location, age, income, interests. Both in designing your products or services, but also down the line when you need to market your products, knowing who the customer is. So try to identify a few of these target customers and try to see the world through their eyes and what are their needs. Create a strategy. As soon as you have a detailed vision to work towards, you want to sit down and draft a strategy on how to get there. Depending on how much time you have to set aside, try drafting a timeline of when you want to hit certain targets. Not that the targets can change at a later date, since your day job always have to take precedent over your side hustle. You don't want to risk your biggest income stream before your side hustle is profitable enough for you to quit your day job. Save money. Set clear savings targets for each month to build up a buffer that you can use for your business. This will be extra important in the early stages of your venture. If your vision is so big that you need investors, you'll need to create a plan for raising money down the line. Learning mindset. There are likely skills that you need to acquire or improve to support your side hustle. Make a list of those skills and ideas on how you want to acquire them. Can it be done by reading books, watching videos, or can you use your current day job to polish those skills? Maybe your day job can even subsidize a training course for you. Take control of time. By far, the hardest thing may be to find time to work on your side hustle. It's usually about priorities though. I would suggest you start by making a time log of where you spend your time today. Are you spending your time well? If not, try to rearrange and remove things that are not bringing you or your family benefits. Then look at the buckets of time that can be channeled into your side hustle. Pay for time. Figure out the things you'd rather pay for than spending your time on, or the things you're bad at that will be more efficient for you to pay for. Then source people to do this work for you on Fiverr or Upwork using whatever budget you have. Make sure you're diligent in researching the best option for your job though. look at sellers' reviews and past deliveries. I'm not asking you to pay it all for this video, but I'd really appreciate if you could hit that like button. It helps me tremendously. Thank you. Seek flexibility. Depending on your situation at work, you may be able to get your boss to give you some wiggle room. Other options would be to work one day less a week or one day less a month, whatever options are economically viable to you. Things like that can give you that focus time that will accelerate your progress and get you closer to that next milestone. Be patient. As with anything else, patience is key. Success comes from putting in effort over time, being relentless and patient. Then suddenly, you will have built up enough of a financial buffer. That day comes when you can leave your day job and focus full time on your side hustle. If I can decide, you go get a pen and paper right now and start drawing up that vision for your side hustle. Taking the first few steps is always the hardest. Getting over that first bump though will make it all way easier. If you found value in this video, please subscribe. I release videos on a weekly basis that will keep adding value to your life and your career. And I just want to leave you with this. The sooner you start, the sooner you will have that business up and running. I wish you the best of luck with this. And I'll see you again next week. Thanks for watching. See you next week.